Today we'll be testing an ascorbic acid formulation. Our goal will be to ascertain the percentage mass of ascorbic acid in this formulation, and we'll be doing so via an acid-based titration. The base that we're going to use in today's experiment has yet to be standardized, so we'll be standardizing it, determining the true concentration, by titrating it against an acid first. Today's experiment is also designed to reinforce your analytical techniques in the lab. It will give you another opportunity to perfect your use of a pipette, to complete a titration, and to weigh out a solid analytically by difference. First of all, deliver 20 mL aliquots of your acid solution into separate conical flasks. To each conical flask, add 3 drops of metacresol purple indicator, and you'll then titrate each of these solutions to the metacresol purple endpoint. This solution will start off a pink color, it will turn yellow when you are close to the end, and you'll have reached the endpoint of this titration when you see a permanent purple color through solution that remains for at least 10 seconds. Once you've completed these titrations, it will then be time to move on to the ascorbic acid analysis. Use a top-loading balance to weigh out approximately 0.4 grams of the ascorbic acid formulation. The exact mass isn't important as long as it is close to that 0.4 grams, somewhere between 0.35 and 0.4 grams will be fine. Then come into the analytical balance room, and here is where we will determine the true mass of ascorbic acid that you are using for analysis. Zero analytical balance with the doors shut, and then place your sample vial, plus your sample, in the balance. Record your mass to 4 decimal places and note that directly down in your result sheet. Then take your sample out of the balance, and then carefully pour your sample into your conical flask. It's important to make sure that you don't spill any of your sample outside the flask. Once you have finished pouring, there may be a small amount of residue left in the vial, and that's fine, it's not an issue. This technique is measuring the mass that you've delivered, the difference. Zero the balance with the door shut, place your sample back in the analytical balance, and record another mass to 4 decimal places. You can record that directly on your result sheet, and then determine the exact mass that you've transferred to your conical flask by calculating the difference between these two masses. Repeat this procedure several times so that you have 4 accurately known masses of ascorbic acid in 4 separate conical flasks. Make sure you know which mass is in which conical flask. Back out in the lab, add 30 or 40 mL of distilled water to each of your conical flasks. This is to dissolve the ascorbic acid so that it's ready for titration. Use a wash bottle to wash down the walls and make sure all of the solid is washed down into the reaction mixture. You'll then once again be titrating your sample using the same metacresol purple indicator. However, this time the titration will begin with the yellow color and will be complete when you once again reach that permanent purple color in solution that doesn't fade after 10 seconds. Be extra careful during these titrations because you're analyzing a different mass of ascorbic acid each time. You won't expect to get the same titer for each analysis. A tip to make your experiment go more smoothly, titrate the sample with the lowest mass first. Then once you know that titer, you can proceed from lowest mass to highest mass and know that your titers should go up in that order as well. Once you've finished your experiment, you can put your results in the spreadsheet up the back and class results will be available. And once again, your experimental write-up will give you an opportunity to practice your stoichiometry and consider the use of analytical equipment in the lab. A final reminder, please make sure you maximize your opportunities today. Take every chance to ensure that your laboratory techniques are in as good a shape as they possibly can be so that you're ready for your practical examination. If you've got any questions, please reach out to your demonstrators. They're more than happy to help. I hope you enjoy it and good luck.